So, McKenzie, thanks for joining us and coming to our booth. And if you would maybe explain yourself, your company, and you know your type of WISP, where you're at, and just give us a little background about your ISP.
Okay. So, like I said, my name is McKenzie. I was interested in wireless for years and years. Probably my interest started when I was, 12, 13. And I didn't really, I was heavy into Linux at that point, so I didn't get as much chance to deal with the wireless side of things. I was dealing more with networking. That was my interest. But eventually I got the opportunity to work at the company I'm at now, which is SPITwSPOTS. And we're based out of a small town in Alaska, Homer, Alaska. And I've been at the company for almost 5 years now. My yearly anniversary is in April of this year. And as we've grown and been able to get more and more subscribers hooked up and get more, employees and stuff, there's always stumbling blocks that you're going to run into. And one of those stumbling blocks is space on your tower and self-interference. I should say two stumbling blocks. And there's, it got to the point where we had actual clients connected to one of our sites. It was 500-600 people. And we caused more of our own issues than anybody else, I'd say. And so we really started looking for a way to mitigate that. And one of those, obviously, is micro repeaters. And so we started doing those and getting clients off of there. And then kind of at the same time, we heard about you guys, RF elements, and this horn antenna. And we really were, it was a very new thing. We love running new stuff. We love testing things. So we were really excited to see what the things that we could possibly see were, what the benefits of it were, basically. And at the same time, Ubiquiti started coming out with a new AC product line. And we were also excited about what these two devices working together would allow us to accomplish. And so what we ended up doing, we finally, through some stumbling that I'm sure you guys are aware of, we finally were able to get our hands on some 30-degree horns and the necessary, twist port adapters. And we basically went, just hard on, this is what we're going to do. We've got three heavily overloaded 45-degree sectors. We need more radio here. We literally cannot connect more people to this. We need more access points. And so we started pushing those out. And like I was saying earlier, on paper, your 30-degree horns are maximum 18.5 dBi gain. That's the maximum you can expect out of them. We were operating on 22 dB passive gain, 45-degree sectors. We're like, we're going to take a chance. We're going to see how it works. And we'll go from there. And we only really saw 1 to 2 dB of loss on customers. We didn't see as much as expected. We did see significantly less noise. Our customers saw less noise. Now our access points are still seeing a lot of noise just due to the density. But our customers hear a lot better, and we're able to provide a lot better signal to them, a lot better transmit, which, let's face it, transmit is what we're about. We want to be able to provide that download to them. So our ability to have a quiet environment for our customers has been fantastic.
Right.
And I've provided you guys the photos of it, but we've got seven of these sitting on the top, I'm gonna say 5 feet of our tower.
Yeah, it's pretty impressive.
Yeah. And
our engineers are like, wow, that's cool.
Yeah, right? Like, so we're excited about that. And we have a few other ones on that tower as well. And this is all co-located with a few other pieces of gear that operate in the 5 gig range.
What kind of CPEs are you using typically on those 30-degree horns?
On the 30-degree horns, like the clients that are actually connected to it, are, primarily we're using rocket dishes, lightweights or solid dishes, with point-to-multipoint rocket ACs.
Cool. If you were to kind of sum up our company in some phrase or short sentence, I mean, how would you describe our company in your opinion? What are your thoughts?
First word that comes to mind, ambitious. I would say you guys are ambitious in trying out two new types of technology that, again, I don't really understand the intricacies of some of it, but trying out kind of being a I haven't seen any other corrugated horn style antennas, so I don't know if there are any other out there, but I'd say almost like an industry leader in it. And I'd be just very interested to see, you know, the first to whatever wins, the first to fiber wins, the first to solar wins, the first to new antenna. You know, if you can really get that going, you can win.